You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we take bot framework and Teams, put them together, and it's pretty awesome. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk a little bit about bots. I got a special guest. Tell us who you are and what you do.
Yeah, I'm Gary Pretty. I'm a senior engineer on the Bot Framework SDK team.
So when I think of bots, right, I basically live in Teams, and yep. I'm like, bots and Teams obviously works together since the beginning, but now there's new stuff. Tell us about what's been there the whole time and then what's new.
Right, yeah, so you've always been able to build a chatbot for Teams, just like you can build it for any of the other channels like Facebook or web chat, etc. But what we really wanted to do as an SDK team is make the developer experience for Teams as awesome as it possibly could be. So the Teams team, who had already done some work to actually build some custom NuGet packages to make the developer experience as straightforward as possible, got together with the Bot Framework SDK team, and the two teams have worked incredibly closely together to make Teams a first-class citizen inside the Bot Framework SDK. So there's now no separate packages to download. As long as you're using the Bot Framework SDK, you've also got the extra bits that you need to build awesome experiences for Teams as well.
I see. And before it was like a connector, or before it was a separate thing?
Yeah, there were separate packages, and you would have to do a lot of the legwork yourself. So, you know, Teams will send a lot of custom events to the bot, depending on what happens. So if somebody joins a channel or somebody sends a message, then events will get sent to your bot. But previously, you had to really manipulate those events yourself. And we tried to abstract as much of that away as possible and just make it super easy to build these experiences.
For those that have never seen a bot actually work in Teams, you have something you can show us?
Yeah, sure. So this is just a really simple example that I've actually pulled straight from our samples repository. Mm-hmm. It's a very, very basic example where, you know, I've got a welcome card here, like an adaptive card or a hero card I could show in Teams. So if I click, you know, update card, that's going to call out to the bot, and the bot's going to go ahead and update that card for me. I could say things like mention me. If I do that, the bot's going to take that event and it's going to say, hey, you know, hello, Gary Pretty. So you can see here that you've got the basic foundations of building a conversational chatbot. So I could send normal text backwards and forwards, but we could be more interactive using these hooks. And the way that that works, if I jump over to Visual Studio and we look at the code behind this, it's all centered around this Teams Activity Handler. So people who build bots regularly will know that we have a basic activity handler, which will handle things like messages, normal messages being received. So as you can see here, this method, if the message comes in, it says mention me, I'm going to call the mention activity async method, and it's going to do what we just saw in the example. The great thing about the Teams activity handler is it extends that the number of methods that you can use to be really team specific. So as an example here, if somebody was to join the conversation, then I actually just get a list of people who've been added to that conversation. I get the information about the team right there. I don't need to do any parsing of the incoming event. It's just done for me, and I can send a message back. So previously, there would have been a lot more code for you to actually go and parse yourself. Another example that I dropped in here is on message reaction activity async. So if somebody does a thumbs up on a message, then we can just send them a message and say, hey, thanks for the reaction. So if I go back to Teams, I do a thumbs up on the previous message, the bot's going to come back and say, hey, thanks for the reaction. So you get some really fantastic abilities to build those traditional conversational experiences out of the box.
That's cool. So I'm looking at this screen right here, is this a conversation that you've started with the bot and that others can join?
So right now I'm having a conversation with the bot, but the bot doesn't just have to work in a one-to-one conversation. The bot can actually be added to a channel. So I can be having a conversation with different team members, and then I could at the bot and ask the bot something, and actually it could help us along in our conversation.
I see.
Yeah.
And so you could literally make a digital assistant in Teams, be like, hey, where's the team going to be over the next couple of weeks? And
right.
You can do stuff like that.
Yep.
Hook it up to O365, stuff like that.
Well, it's interesting because we've got something called the Virtual Assistant Project, which provides you with like an enterprise class best practice bot with capabilities like calendar, O365 integration, to-do integration. And actually you can take that and add that that into Teams and use that day-to-day in Teams to book your meetings, read your emails, you know, it's really, really clever stuff.
And so speaking of samples, I mean, you mentioned the sample, which is it open source? Is it something I can build in? Are there other examples of things that I can do?
Yeah, sure. So if we just jump over here, the bot builder samples repository, so github.com/Microsoft/bot builder samples. We've got a ton of samples in here that we work really hard to maintain and keep up to date. And as part of those samples, we have specific examples around Teams. And the samples I'm showing here are the .NET Core samples, but we also have the same samples in JavaScript, and also we have two other SDKs for Python and Java as well.
Oh, that's fantastic. So the one that you were actually showing here was one of these samples.
That's right, yeah. So anybody can go to this samples repository, clone the repo, and within a few minutes, they can be up and running with a bot in Teams. So it comes with the Teams app manifest that you need to actually install the app into Teams. It's got all of the instructions there, and it literally takes a few minutes to get going. And the nice thing about the samples is if you're working on a bot, we try and keep the samples as small and focused as possible so that you can actually just jump in, find the code that you need. You know, maybe, for example, I'll show in a minute, a Teams messaging extension. Mm-hmm. You can grab the code that you need and you're on your way.
Well, let's talk about these extensions. So you said Teams messaging extension. I was like, okay, what is that and how do I do it?
So the best thing to do is probably show you an example of one. So Teams supports a few different app types, and message extensions is one of them. And specifically, I'm going to show you a search messaging extension. So the example, and again, this is part of our samples repository, so you can go and get up and running with this straight away, is this NuGet search extension. So you can almost imagine.
Let's pause right here because I'm looking at this. When you put at NuGet, that is calling an extension.
So yes, that's right. So we've installed a Teams app, which surfaces this NuGet search extension for me.
I see. Okay. Yeah. So the Teams app that you're installing is going to have extensions as well as bot interaction.
So you can have an app that's a bot. You can have an app that's a Teams messaging extension that's search, or you can have an action-based search extension. There's loads of different things that you can do with bots in Teams.
I see, that's cool.
Hence why we have the several different examples to show you how you can get going.
Makes sense.
So to show you what we can do here, let's imagine I'm having a conversation with another developer on my team, and they say to me, hey, which NuGet package should I use for this particular scenario? So right here, I've at the search extension, and I've now got this search box. I could have done that up here in the search window as well. And if I now just do, bot builder, that's going to go away and actually do a search of NuGet packages. Mm-hmm. It could be anything, right? And I can then pick one of those NuGet packages. That's then going to add a card for that NuGet package into the messaging window. And I can actually just send that. And the bot's brought the welcome card up because we've the default behavior in our sample is just to show you the welcome card if it doesn't understand what you're saying, just so you can get an idea of how these things work. What I think is really important to take away from this is previously it would have taken potentially hundreds of lines of code to write something like this. You know, and you can see that experience is really nice. We're using all the richness that's in Teams.
Right.
But we want to make sure it's as easy as possible to actually build that experience. And if we jump over back to Visual Studio, and we have a look at the code behind it, it's just two methods. So we've got method one, which is on Teams messaging extension query async. So every time I type into that search box, as I'm typing, it's sending a query into this method. This method will do the NuGet search and then simply creates a list of preview cards, which are the ones that we saw in the list, and a list of cards that should be added to the chat window if I select one. And the second method is the messaging extension select item async. And all that is doing is taking the JSON from the card that we created before and putting that in the messaging window. So you're talking, 50 lines of code all up to build that awesome experience.
Yeah, but they're not even like, some of them aren't even like real lines of code. It's basically newing up stuff.
Exactly,
right?
Yeah.
Which and
it's
cool.
It's building out attachments. It's the nice thing about it is none of this is you trying to manipulate Teams, because we're doing that for you.
Okay, so there's been a lot of concepts thrown at us. You talked about messaging extensions. You talked about bots and Teams. Are they separate things? It looks like you're building it all in the same place.
Right. So they the common sort of way to do it is if you want to build a messaging extension, you would install that as a Teams app, okay. and that's going to be backed by a bot. If you want then to have a conversational bot, you have a separate app, and that's going to be backed by a bot. So you know how I said at NuGet search extension?
Yeah.
That's one bot. When I said I was having the conversation before, it's called Teams Conversation Bot, if you mm-hmm. switch back over. So I could at Teams Conversation Bot if I wanted to as well.
I see.
Yeah. And the nice thing about it is these things can be surfaced all over Teams. But I'm really just scratching the surface because we can do things like notifications. We can, when we're in Visual Studio, if we actually switch back over to the conversation bot, if I show you, the different methods that I can override, then you can see the number of different events that we can actually get. So when members are added, when members are removed, when we receive a reaction, when a channel name changes, when someone's added to a channel, when the bot joins a conversation, we can actually react to all of those events. And it really allows you to really light up that whole experience in Teams. And we just want to get out of your way. We want to allow you to call out to those third-party services, call out to 0365, really do whatever you want to provide for your customers and your users. And we don't want you to be really worried about having to interpret all of those events that are coming backwards and forwards from Teams.
I see. So basically, you can install apps that can be bots.
Yep.
You can create a number of different functionalities backed by the bot framework to do a number of different things collaboratively.
Exactly.
Well,
yeah.
This has been amazing. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you again for watching. We've been learning all about how to use the bot framework in Teams and all the new functionality that's in there. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.